Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this video, we're going to see about what is Power Query, Power Pivot, and Power View, how they are related to Power BI. If you are familiar with Power BI, and if you search in Google, you often come across these terminologies, Power Query, Power Pivot, Power BI, and you always confused with that if you're new to the business intelligence world. In this video, I will explain what are those tools and how it is related. Let's jump into action. Before seeing about these tools, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. We are familiar with this architecture. Power BI consists of Power BI desktop, and it contains Power BI services and mobile access. And nowhere the architecture of Power BI is these three tools: Power Pivot, Power Query, or Power View. Let's see what is those history of it, these tools. Basically, all these three tools, Power Query, Power Pivot, Power View, are came as an Excel add-ins, and each tool solves its own purpose. When we start with Power Query, it is used to perform ETL, that is extract, transform, and load operations. Let's see more on this in next slide. And it uses the M language. It stands for mashup language. Basically, it is a Power Query extension language. They want to shorten form of it. So mashup means it's called many purpose. So they named it as M language. So Power Query uses M language to perform ETL. And Power Pivot, it is used to perform modeling or create relationship between tables. So when you create relationship, it internally creates a structure or data architecture like cubes, SSAS tabular model cubes, that stores your data in a column store engine. It requires some kind of modeling. That is what the Power Pivot is meant for. To query this model, we need a language called DAX. This is what a Power Pivot is all about. And you have a Power View. It's used to visualize data in charts and graphs or maps and some other formats. So this is the purpose of these three tools, and all these tools came as an Excel add-ins. So how it is related to Power BI? Let's see more about Power Query. So Power Query, if you see here, we have data in many places like Excel, database, web. As I said, Power BI can able to bring all the data. It's not the Power BI does that. Basically, underlying layer is Power Query. So Power Query brings the data from different sources, and it can do some transformation. Like you have data from customer data from Excel, and you have that phone numbers in database, you need to merge it, or you need to remove certain rows from the Excel, top rows, bottom rows, remove blank rows, or you have different. So these kind of transformation can be done in Power Query. So this Power Query engine will does that purpose, right? And gives you a data in a table format, because Power BI is a column store database. It requires data in a table format, so it transforms the data into table. Even you can get the data from JSON format. So these kind of transformation, this is what basically the ETL stands for. Extracts the data from different sources, transform it to your format that is suitable for Power BI, then gives you in a tabular format, database world, but here it loads into Power BI itself. Okay, so this is Power Query all about. Power Pivot, if you see familiar with this, we have a model. So creating a relationship will give you a model, and creating your measures, columns, all these things are part of Power Pivot only. Let's see it here. So this is the summary. Like Power Query does your transformation, and your Power Pivot, as I said in the initial slide, Power Pivot creates a cube. Cube is nothing but your data structure that stores the data in a more compressed format. Then there comes a Power View. So the Power View is a combination of all your maps and question and answer charts, everything. Okay, these are the parts of it. So you are familiar with these three terminologies: ETL, modeling, and visualization. So if you are spending most of the time here, if you have a proper model in place, 80% of the development process happens here, and your querying or viewing part is very simple. You need to spend only 20%. But if your modeling part or your querying part is not so perfect, then you can't able to have a good visualization, or you can't able to solve your purpose of your business requirement. So please focus on this part, okay? Your modeling part especially. Okay, let's try to explore this options in Power BI Desktop. What is Power Query, Power Pivot, and Power Map? How so that we can correlate whatever we have seen right now. Let's head towards our Power BI Desktop. So when you are launching Power BI Desktop, you will have a page like this, and you have reports. So let's try to correlate these three things. So the transform data is nothing but your Power Query editor. If you see the description tooltip, use the Power Query editor to connect, prepare, and transform data. As the description indicates, it's used to transform your data. So click on it, and you will get a screen like this, right? Power Query editor. So here what you can do, so this is the page you are familiar with. If you are watching my previous video, you have a list of tables, and you can do the certain transformation. You can split column, merge queries, join, append queries, or remove certain rows, and you can navigate through the steps. All these things we are familiar with. So these are this is the place where you do the actual ETL operations. This is what your Power Query is all about. Then what is your Power Pivot? So Power Pivot, once you do the transformation, all your tables listed here, and here is the modeling tab where you create the relationship. This is already created. If you are not create a relationship, these three tables are not related. There won't be any lines between these two tables, which indicates a relationship. So you need to create a relationship using manage relationship or drag and drop. This is one of the important part of your modeling. Along with that, you can also create a measure and calculated columns. These are also part of your Power Pivot operation only. And finally, we have Power View, where you can create visualizations, maps, other things. Already we have created certain visuals here. So these are part of your Power View. So when you kickstarted your career or you are learning Power BI, no need to mess up with all these things. This is just for your understanding or the history of Power BI. So then what is Power BI? Power BI, nothing but it bundles all these tools as a single powerful business intelligence tool. So you no need to worry about whether you are in Power Query or Power View or Power BI. So basically you need to understand the Power BI combination of these three tools, and Microsoft doesn't want you to confuse with different tools. So it bundles and gives us a powerful business intelligence tool. That is what Power BI. I hope you guys understand. So if you like this video, subscribe to the channel and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.